The Philippine poll body takes steps to officially end the country's election season. The Election Commission deleted from the servers of the National Printing Office digital files of ballot faces used for the May 9 polls. The deleted files contained over 1,600 ballot faces. The deletion was meant to ensure no further ballots are printed. The Commission on Elections begins preparing for the upcoming village and youth council polls this December. This despite reports the incoming administration may push for the postponement of the elections.
Naghahanda kami ng ating mga yung ating mga activity plans for the barangay elections, and we're already starting internal discussions on the various scenarios that we will be playing out. Hindi naman talaga nagre-recommend ng COMELEC, no, ng postponement, no. It's not something that we do. As far as the COMELEC is concerned, if the elections are in the books, if scheduled already, then we will go through with it.
COMELEC also says the pandemic will still be factored in as it prepares for the upcoming elections.
Remember, nasa panahon pa rin tayo ng pandemya. And so we're still planning very carefully all of these procedures that we hope that will make the barangay elections safe.
Later, Representative Martin Romualdez, who is being pushed to be the next speaker, has said the House of Representatives is eyeing postponing the upcoming village and youth council elections. This to save funds for a renamed stimulus bill. Retired political science professor Clarita Carlos is appointed by Philippine President-elect Marcos to be his national security advisor. Dr. Carlos was once the president of the National Defense College and previously acted as the government's consultant in peace talks with the Moro Islamic Liberation. Also chose House Deputy Speaker Conrado Estrella III to lead the Agrarian Reform Department. The Abono Partilist representative is the grandson of Conrado Estrella Sr., who once served as the Agrarian Reform Minister in the administration of the President-elect's father. Carlos and Estrella accepted the offer to join the incoming administration following a two-hour meeting Wednesday at Marcos's headquarters in Mandaluyong City. Outgoing and incoming Philippine leaders greet the Filipino-Chinese community as they mark the 21st Filipino-Chinese Friendship Day. President-elect Marcos hailed what he noted as the great gains from the Philippines' relationship with China. He said he looks forward to more fruitful engagements in the two countries' friendship.
The centuries-old relationship and friendship of the Philippines and China has been and will continue to be of great mutual benefit to our people. From trade, arts, culture, athletics, to regional peace and stability, to the employment of opportunities for our people, and all the significantly generous efforts extended to us during the pandemic, the cooperative partnership of our two nations continued to reach new heights.
Vice President-elect Sara Duterte spoke in a recorded message in which she hoped to achieve new milestones with the Filipino-Chinese community. The celebration held via video conference also marked in advance the 124th anniversary of Philippine independence. Outgoing Philippine President Rodrigo Duterte sent a recorded greeting saying the occasion should remind Filipinos how their forefathers fought for the freedom they enjoy today. Transport regulators have approved a 1 peso fare hike for public utility jeepneys effective today, June 9. This is in response to a petition filed by transport groups amid the unabated rise in fuel prices. The fare increase will bring the base fare, or the first 4 kilometers, to 10 pesos. The fare hike is limited to the National Capital Region as well as Regions 3 and 4. Discounts will still be given to persons with disability, senior citizens, and students. Meanwhile, the regulatory board will hear a separate petition to increase the base fare by 5 pesos on June 28, the last week of the Duterte administration.
The Philippines' health chief claims the country has now contained the threat of COVID-19. Secretary Francisco Duque III says daily cases did not see a spike despite mass gatherings during the election campaign season. But Duque still urges the public to remain cautious as the virus may further mutate.
Given our measures, our interventions, mukhang contained na siya, no? And the data will support that claim. But at the same time, we are realistic to accept the fact that this virus is notorious for mutations. It is capable of springing surprises at every turn.
Duque, meanwhile, rejected calls to shut borders amid the monkeypox threat, but he adds he has ordered strict monitoring and surveillance for the virus.
It is premature to be closing borders to travelers from these endemic areas. Ang utos ko last May 7 sa BOQ is to be very strict, to enforce strict screening standards, symptom screening. No? Galing sa mga endemic countries or non-endemic countries with risk of monkeypox, dapat alamin yung symptoms.